Welcome back to another week of SoCal Business and Basketball Report. This is Ray Dietz. Tonight we're at Harvard Westlake High School, where Beverly Hills High School played Harvard Westlake, just over the hill from Beverly Hills and the Bel Air area. But before we get into the game, I just wanted to close the loop on Jalen Green from last week, where I mentioned that I didn't think that he should go to Kentucky. And again, he's only a junior in high school, but a few people asked me about that this week. And I think it's a very delicate thing when someone chooses their future path and what coaches, what players are gonna be around. And I think Jalen's the kind of guy who needs some freedom. He's very athletic, he can catch and shoot, he's on the wing and very athletic, but a couple of players I remember, Roderick Rhodes, who went to Kentucky, was widely known as the number one player in his class, and Felipe Lopez was possibly the top player in his class, if not very close to it. And Felipe did play 4 years in the NBA. Roderick played 3 years in the NBA, which is very good, but I think the expectations that they would do much better. So I think it's very delicate. I think some players, they need some freedom. And I think that Jalen, if he gets into some program where you have to learn 50 defenses, and it could possibly thwart him. I think he needs to be where they just kind of roll the ball out, let you play. And a place like Memphis, UCLA, Oregon, where he's going to have some freedom. Make sure that there's a good point guard where he's going. I think that could be a major thing. So I think he's got a promising future. I think he's more athletic than Felipe Lopez and Roderick Rhodes were. But let's give him some space here and let him develop in his own time. So we're here at Harvard Westlake. Through the years, Harvard Westlake has had some very good basketball players. You had the Collins twins from Stanford and also of the NBA. They went here. Alex Stevenson, who was recruited by all the major programs in the country, went to North Carolina, transferred back to USC. And then he eventually got some time in the NBA as well. Jonathan Martin, the football player that had some trouble in the Miami Dolphins locker room, he played football here, and you know it was a major story for a while, the troubles he had with Richie Incognito. And this is one of the better, probably the best academic school in Los Angeles. And when Jonathan's football coach at Harvard Westlake was asked about the situation, he said, well, our guys go to Harvard, they go to Stanford, they go to Rice, and those are the kind of locker rooms they fit in. So who knows, but the point is, it is a very good academic school here. So the area, we're just over the hill from Beverly Hills, Bel Air. Griffith Park is a widely known park nearby. Coldwater Canyon Park is a park known nearby as well. Through the years, I had a few clients who donated to Tree People, which is affiliated with Coldwater Park here. But the Franklin Canyon Park, which is nearby, is less known. There's less signage, but that's actually where the opening scene from the Andy Griffith Show was filmed, nearby here. So it's a very peaceful area, basically right in the middle of Los Angeles. And so that is nearby, and there's a good amount of filming that's done in this area. In terms of Beverly Hills High School, Chance Comanche, 6'10 player that went to Arizona a few years ago, spent a couple of years there and moved on to the G League. He played at Beverly Hills High School. Sam Nazarian is a big name from Beverly Hills High School. He was the guy behind CLS Hotel in Las Vegas in the Beverly Hills area. Big with the nightclubs in the LA area, where he would promote and develop nightclubs that had very big followings. And he actually redid the gym at Beverly Hills High School several years ago. Basically did that for him, so he's been a big part of that community. very large Persian population at the Beverly Hills High School, so that's good to know as well. In terms of the business environment in Beverly Hills, there's some very nice restaurants, of course. Spago, which is Wolfgang Puck's restaurant, the Palm Restaurant, that was in West Hollywood for years and moved to Beverly Hills a few years ago, very nice restaurant. Cedars-Sinai Medical Center, right on the edge of Beverly Hills in Los Angeles, one of the best medical centers in the whole West Coast. And then Live Nation, the concert promoter, calls Beverly Hills home for its corporate headquarters. They were the former Clear Channel. They merged with Ticketmaster, so they're handling the whole music and event promotion business. Tonight's game, we had Harvard-Westlake did prevail, 58-53. Johnny Juzang, who's had offers from all the major programs, basically, he did not play tonight. He's a junior, so he's got another year. So Mason Hooks, their 6'10 junior, had to do a little more work tonight, and they worked hard. It was a close game all the way. Mason doesn't have a lot of spring, but he really works hard. He's got a strong upper body. He did hit a three tonight, threw one down with a dunk, and hit a number of foul shots. So they got the win, and we'll see moving forward. Of note, Cassius Stanley started his career here at Harvard-Westlake before he transferred to Sierra Canyon. Right now, Sierra Canyon is the number one rated team in the state. That pretty much does it for tonight. We're heading into the holidays here, so we'll have a couple of wrinkles for you in the next few weeks. Thanks for joining us. We will be at another neighborhood of interest next week, and we'll end the show here with Andy Griffith style with the old song. We're,